Moving on, in the other game of the day, Konkola Blades came up against Nkwazi Football Club. Nkwazi Football Club from Lusaka, traveling all the way from Lusaka province to the Copper Belt to face Konkola Blades in the border town of Chilabombwe. It didn't get any easier for Nkwazi as they crashed 3-0. Nkwazi were expected to do well, especially after they had beaten 2013 champions Nkana at home at Nkana Stadium 1-0 just 2 weeks ago. They were expected to do even better this time against Konkola Blades, a side, well, which hasn't done so well, but unfortunately they crashed 3-0. Goals from Davy Kalandanya, Eric Chomba and Nasha Kaya gave Konkola Blades the 3-0 win, a very easy win for them. Davy Kalandanya, well, the petite midfielder, was in such great form that fans at Konkola Stadium were calling for his inclusion into the Zambia national team, which will travel to the COSAFA Cup in South Africa to face other teams in the COSAFA tournament. Davy Kalandanya, well, great performance, great control, and boy oh boy, what a first goal he scored. If you saw it on TV, well, anyone would be impressed. Now, focusing on the Zambia Super League log. Interested to know who's at the top, who's at the bottom? Well, Green Eagles, previously before this game, they were at the top of the Zambia Super League. No team which has been at the top of the Zambia Super League by the fourth game in the league has ever won the league title in the last 4 years. So people are interested to know, will Green Eagles continue to be at the top of the league? Unfortunately, that's not so, because Power Dynamos leapfrogged them into first place. Although they are on the same number of points, all on 9 points, Green Eagles earned 9 points because of their draw against Mufula Wanderers away. So this is how the table looks. Power Dynamos are at the top of the table on 9 points. In second place are Konkola Blades on 9 points. And in third place are Green Eagles on 9 points. Now what separates them is just goal difference. Power Dynamos have scored 7 goals, conceded none, which gives them a +7 goal aggregate, while the other two teams have a less goal aggregate. And the fact that Power Dynamos have played 2 less games because of their continental commitments means that, well, Power Dynamos, well, if they win the other 2 games, they'll still be on top. But right now, that's how the table looks, the top three. At position number 4 is Zanaco Football Club on 8 points, while position number 5 is Nchanga Rangers, and position number 6 is Nkwazi Football Club. That's how the top 6 looks like. Now, this is a very important program in Zambian football. Why we have brought this to you is, obviously, we have noticed that a lot of people are interested in the Zambian Super League. A lot of people are interested in football. We love football. You love football. So we sat down and thought, well, how can we bring you closer to the game? Obviously, you want to see what exactly is happening, which players are doing what, which clubs are interested in what, and are doing what exactly. So we brought you this program so that you can be able to get closer to the Zambian Super League and closer to Zambian football. But with that said, we would want your input, because this is your show. We want to know what exactly you want us to put in the show and how you will best enjoy it. So if you have any contributions, all you can do is send it to our Facebook page, Zambian Super League fan page, or all you have to do is just search for it on Facebook, Zambian Super League fan page. You'll find it, and just drop your comments, drop any suggestions you have. We'll be interested to know. We also have a YouTube page, Zambian Super League YouTube page. You can just search for it. All our videos will be uploaded there. If you have any comments, any suggestions, just drop them there. And this has been a great show. Obviously, we've all enjoyed it. See you next time.